What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to ICNV Drives Edition. Like I told you before, I had a chance to sit down with two event winners from Corvettes and Carlisle. So right now, I'm going to get into the Celebrity Choice Award. Let's get into this video about one of the winners of the Celebrity Choice Award. Let's go. Before we get too started into this video, please go ahead and hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. This is ICNV Drivers Edition. We like to have interesting conversations, a little playing around, and we do a lot of things like go on trips, road trips, events, and things like that. So it's an interesting channel to be part of and probably have some fun with. So if you're looking for something, a good way to pass your time, check out the channel. Now, before I dive really, really deep into this conversation, I'm going to give you a quick rundown on how my man Terry, if you haven't heard, I've talked about him several videos before. He's out of Memphis. He's a great guy. I always enjoy hanging out with him and his wife when it comes time to go into events, car shows, Corvette events, and things of that nature. So while we were in Carlisle, I was hanging out with my man Terry, and I got caught up with somebody else that was a follower of the channel, got into a conversation with them, and my man Terry said, I'm gonna go back to my car real quick, get some water and cool off. Him and his wife walked to their car, which was probably parked maybe a quarter of a mile from the Arilari parking area. So as I was talking to one of my subscribers, and I really appreciate his time and stopping by in the conversation we shared, and you've seen it in my previous video, as I was talking to them, my man Terry went to his car, and as he was at his car, he met a nice couple. And the couple were looking at his vehicle, and they asked him, was he local, you know, how was the drive? Well, Terry went to explain, oh, I'm actually out of Memphis, and I drove here from Memphis. It was like a 13-hour drive. And he was like, oh, wow, really? And you did that inside the Corvette? He was like, actually, I actually did. It wasn't that bad of a drive. You know, I have a newer Tahoe, and honestly, the ride was so smooth in the Corvette and comfortable, I couldn't tell the difference between my Tahoe from the Corvette. So the individual was like, wow, really, that's a nice compliment for the vehicle. He was like, yeah, it's great engineering. And he went on to explain more about his Corvette, from the modifications he was looking to do to it, to the modifications that had already been done before he purchased it, and why he liked his car, how much he paid for his car, and his future plans for the car. And as crazy as this sounds, as he's sitting there going over like the 6.2 liter V8 and all this interesting information about his 2LT Z51 edition Corvette, the gentleman is just sitting there listening with a smile on his face. And so the wife made a comment saying, hey, we drove down in the Corvette too. We drove down in the Z06. And my man Terry, without missing the beat, said, oh, really? C7? C6? Now, before I spoil the story, I'm going to let my man Terry explain it to you. That way I won't butcher it up like my man neighbor Mark did. But it's a great story, and neighbor Mark was a part of it. So I'm going to let Terry explain to you what happened.
Love it. He said, where'd you come from? Maryland? I said, no, we came from Tennessee. We drove 13 hours. He said, sure. Well, how did you like the ride? I said, it was beautiful. It's like riding in my Tahoe. I got a new Tahoe. Uh-huh. I said, it was comfortable. I couldn't tell I was in the Corvette or the Tahoe.
Right.
He said, oh, wow, nice. He said, what you got on the car? I started explaining the engine to him, all the little different aesthetics on the car, I said, hey, man, you want to check this out? I was showing him different things. And he said, well, the wife said, we drove up in a Z06. I said, oh, wait, we got a C7 Z06? He said, no. We got a C8 Z06. It's young. I was like, well, you're a celebrity. I said, hey, Bermar. he said, no, I've heard of him, but no, I'm not neighbor Mark. You know, I looked at her, and I looked at it. I said, that's Tadge.
Oh, it was Tadge.
Look what he did.
Nice.
He gave him the celebrity award.
Aww.
He won from Tadge. Tadge hands this to
him. And he gets the
front row. It turns out that his the wife's brother is a Chicago police officer.
No shit. Yeah.
That's what
Tadge is
like.
A great guy.
Yes.
That really nice awesome. Guy. Real nice guy.
He is.
But he knows who neighbor Mark is.
Okay. Wow. Now, I'm going to ask you an honest question. Your time in Chicago PD, what was the best police car you ever had as far as the
probably don't like me a lot, but they like my
car. I've been on 29 years, so I came on with the box.
That's before they left.
The box Caprice, yes.
The box Caprice had a better turning radius.
Right.
When they came out with the pumper, that thing wouldn't turn around worth nothing.
Really?
No.
You didn't have that? Because I had one.
They gave us the SUVs.
You know what? No, you're right. Yeah. You know why? You know what? I know what you're saying. You're talking about low-speed turn radius.
Right.
Please hit the like button. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it already. This is ICNV Drivers Edition. We like to have decent conversations. I have conversations about topics you guys bring up because I love to interact with my ICNV Drivers Edition community. So join the community, subscribe to the channel. It's the easiest way to show support without any monetary value. But also, if you want to help support the channel, please look into our website and buy some merchandise to help support the channel. Now, let's get back into this video.
Now, what I find amazing about the story is, one, I was a little upset that I wasn't there because I should have been there. And then two, is the fact that Tadge was actually that cool. So Tadge not only knowing who neighbor Mark is was actually kind of funny. And then two, the fact that he actually sat back and let my man Terry explain to him the Corvette as if he had never seen it before or knew any information about it was amazing to me. Because to me, I feel like at that moment, Tadge was embracing what he created. He was understanding what the Corvette C8 has done to so many people. It's really a vehicle that they are proud of, proud to own, and a lot of people love their cars, and that's why I myself went to Corvettes in Carlisle. Because when you go out to Corvette events, you meet a lot of nice owners, a lot of interesting people, and many of these people are very proud of their car, whether they made any modifications to them or it's completely stock. But one thing that all the Corvette owners share in common is they are very proud of their car, and everybody at some point doesn't mind telling you about their car, what they like about it, and why they bought it, or why they drive it, or why they did this, or why they did that when it comes to modifications, changes, and so forth. So at the end of the day, that's the beauty of the Corvette community, is events bring us together. And sitting back as Tadge, which I wish I could have had an opportunity to talk to him about that, and I won't lie to you, I had an opportunity to speak to Tadge all of 13 seconds, and all I could honestly say was, thank you for bringing the mid-engine Corvette to life. I kind of felt like Rick Conti, because I felt like, if nothing else, I need to say, thank you, Tadge. But out of all the questions that I could have asked Tadge, the one question I would have asked him is, how does it feel, especially in that moment where somebody doesn't recognize you or quite understand who you are and how instrumental you were to them even owning their vehicle, but them sitting back telling you about it as if you have no idea what it is or what it does or how it was engineered, or there isn't information about this car all across the internet. So it's the moments like these that I think will always make me attend some form of a Corvette event at least once or twice a year. Because I enjoy conversating with people, and I really
enjoy seeing the modifications that people make to their cars. I enjoy hearing the conversations, the dialogue, and enjoy hearing the different experiences that people have had with their cars and how much people actually love their vehicles. I think we all can agree this was a very interesting story. I don't think it could have happened to a nicer person than my man Terry out of Memphis. And I would like to appreciate or thank him for sharing his story with us. And I hope you enjoyed hearing it. So, ICNV Drivers Edition, please hit the like and subscribe. Share the video. It's one of those fun moments that we all can embrace and every Corvette owner should enjoy and love. Until next time, stay blessed, stay safe, and I'll see you in these streets. Peace.